In this video, we're going to go through the process of adding a new sales order in MYOB Advanced. First of all, we want to go into the order type. Make sure we selected the correct type, and this allows us to select the type of order we would like to create. For example, it could be either an invoice type, a returns type, or an order sales order type, depending on what we select from the list. Let's leave it as sales order for now. Next, we want to go and select the customer account. Now, we can either type part of a word in here so it searches the customer database, or we can click the magnifying glass to do the search for the customer. Let's go ahead and select our customer from the list. Next, we want to select our date, which is the order date, and then requested on date is when the customer needs this order by. The customer order number is their purchase order number that we can fill in here. External reference number is any other reference that we want to populate in the system. The description is any description we want to add for this order, and it is not a mandatory field. Next, we want to go to the details section and click the plus icon to start adding in our stock items. So let's navigate to the inventory ID field where we can select our first item either by typing into the field or clicking the magnifying glass to select. So if we start typing in part of the word, it will search and find our results, which we can select. In this example, we'll select the apple jam product. Next, the warehouse has pre-populated based on the item setup. If we click on the magnifying glass, we can see all the warehouses in the system, and it also shows us the quantity on hand for each of these. We'll go ahead and select our warehouse, and next the unit of measure can be selected if this is in use. Next, we want to select the quantity that is on the order, and the unit price will pre-populate based on the setup of the item or the sales prices from the receivables module. Also note that in the information down the bottom, we can see the on-hand quantity of this item, the available and the available for shipping information. The available for shipping is the information that's relevant to this sales order, as this is the available stock to ship. Next, we're going to add a new line by clicking the plus icon again, but in this case, we're going to use a different method. We're going to click the Add Items button, which will allow us to select from a list of items and select the quantities. So we will filter our list just so we can see the warehouse we are interested in. And then we're going to navigate to our next item, which is the orange jams. Select the checkbox, and in the Quantity Selected field, we're going to enter our quantity and then click Add and Close to add this record to the order. Note how the quantity is updated and the unit price has also been set automatically based on the setup of the item. Note that the order total has been updated with the information from our items. Also, we've got the GST taxable total, which is excluding GST. Then we've got the tax total that has also been calculated. And then finally, we've got the inclusive tax amount here. If we go through the tabs, the taxes tab will show the calculation of our GST. Commissions will show the salesperson linked to this order and if there's any commission calculations. The financial tab will show us all our financial information for this order. The shipping tab will show us any information about the shipping rules and any packages that we might have included. The address tab will give us information about the shipping address and the billing address, as well as the contact information. The discounts tab, if this is enabled, will calculate any kind of discounts. The shipments tab will show us any shipments that were created from this order. The payments tab will allow us to create payments or prepayments that are linked to this sales order. And then finally, the totals tab gives us all sorts of metrics about this order in terms of the weights, the volumes, any freight calculations. If that's set up, it will be shown in here as well. If we click back to the details tab, we can review our entries and then save this order. Notice, the next number in the sequence has been added to this order in the order number field. We cover additional MYOB advanced workflows in other videos.